morning and welcome back to Rosie's Picks at Oakville Paper Boutique. Today's little tutorial is actually on how to do your own guest book. So I'm going to discuss first of all the materials that I'm using. For the cover, I'm using something that's known as either millboard or esker board. You can also use what's on the back of notepads. That's often thick enough as well. So I'm using two pieces, and ideally my book is going to be 7x10 as a finished guest book style. So once you have your pieces cut to 7x10, what you will need to do is create the opening portion, because you need to be able to open up the cover but still have the guest book bound on the side. So without creating this gap, it won't open properly. So that's the next portion of what I'm doing. So I use just the width of my ruler, because I find that that is actually ideal. So I'll cut that portion off. Now, because you don't want to be able to have to open it too close to the edge, you actually want to trim a little bit off of this piece to ensure that you have the gap for it to open properly. The thicker the paper that you're using for the cover, the wider the gap will need to be to allow for some flexibility. So once I cut that off, I'm then ready to start working on putting the pieces onto the paper that I'm using to cover it with. So for practice, it's always a good idea to start with your back cover first. Get a feel for the materials, how thick they are, and how well they're going to glue. Now I'm using a tape gun, but you can also use double-sided tape for this. So I want to get all the way around the edge, and the tape gun does the trick of holding it in place if you have a heavy enough tape to use. And if you're using a handmade paper, you can just use a glue stick. That will work beautifully. So place it onto your paper. It can be centered if you like, but I'm just putting a little off center. I'm going to actually trim off the excess, smooth it down, make sure you don't have any wrinkles. And then I'm just, again, the same width of the ruler, trim off the excess paper that we don't need. Now, the next portion of this is we want to be able to fold this quite easily around the cover of the book. So I am going to score the pieces around the edge using a bone folder. Or, as I've said in a previous video, a pen that doesn't work will do just as well. So I'm going to crease it a few times because the paper I'm working with is actually quite thick. And so you're literally creating an indentation in the paper along the edge, which will allow it to fold a little bit more easily. So once you go around all the sides, what you're going to do is you're going to start with the corner, you're going to bring the corner right in, and then crease it down. So ideally, you have an edge that looks like this, and that will allow you to glue this and not have it bulk up on the corner. So it actually takes away a little bit of the thickness once you've got that in place. So crease it down again, do that on all four sides. Then you can open it up, and again with double-sided tape, just along the edge, you can glue it down. Again, make sure your corners are nice and tight, because you want them to look sharp as opposed to rounded out. And then finish your glue on the insides of those, and then you can start just pushing your pieces in, make sure they're folding nicely, crease it down with your bone folder, and then that's essentially what your corners are going to look like. So for the next portion of this tutorial, we're going to be working on the cover. So what I've done, the same as what I did the back cover, glued it onto the sheet and I'm doing the corners, I've glued the front cover onto the backing, and I've left the gap for it to be able to open. So again, you're going to be doing the same thing with the corners. You're going to be scoring it and then pushing them down all the way around. Now in between these two pieces, you want to be able to score those as well, because it has to be able to open with a little bit of flexibility. So on the other side, you'll actually see the indentations. So what I do is I just usually fold this back and forth a little bit, because you really need the flexibility if it's a stiff paper. If it's a very stiff paper, you don't want it to crack. So you need to kind of work on it a little bit to soften it and get it moving more easily. and then you can really see where you have your fold. So then the next portion again is just to glue all the way around and then to do the corners. So for this portion, this side where I've done my bind is going to be exactly the same as what I've done before. Now, because I've used this ruler width, it's a great width, I'm actually gluing it before the edge here so that it doesn't bulk up when I go to open the book. So once you've done all the corners and you get it all done all the way around, the next portion is going to be to bind the book and how to do the holes in. Once your cover is done and all the pieces are glued down and you've got your binding score here, you're ready to do the inside of the cover. Now, I have used these pages just the same as what I'm using for my guestbook pages, and I've cut them to 6¾ by 9¾ because my book is 7 by 10. So I place that down, do the same for the back cover. Now, because it's a lightweight paper, I don't need to really do a score for the bind, but if I was using a heavier weight paper, I would need to score it. So once you have that in place, take your pages, place them in the book, take your cover, and then you need to measure where you want the holes to go so that you can do your binding. Now, for the book this size, I find 4 holes is sufficient, and you want them close enough in that your covers don't slide around. So I've already predetermined my measurements for 7 by 10. So the measurements I've got listed are 2 centimeters, 6.6 centimeters, 11.2 centimeters, and 15.8 centimeters. So I just mark that on. And then what I'm going to do is I've actually got a drill press that allows me to drill all the holes at once. If you don't have a drill press, you can use a hole punch, but obviously it's going to take a lot longer. But you can use a 3-hole punch. You just have to reset up your measurements for your pages. You can do a few at a time. And then for the cover, you may actually have to mark it off and then do your drill. So the next portion of what I've done so far is I have now drilled my holes and I'm ready to bind my book. So I'm just using a very simple method involving ribbon and a needle, just because it makes it easier to thread it through the book. So start sort of in the middle of the book, and then you're going to wind yourself around to get the crisscross pattern, and then back through the next hole. Very simple stitch method. And I like using satin ribbon because it is very strong. I like to cover my ends because it keeps the cover a little bit more secure. So you continue doing that all the way through. Come up to the top end. You can also use other methods of binding your book. For example, if you don't want a ribbon because you feel it just looks too busy, you can also use something called Chicago screws, which are basically a little screw, and they're available at most hardware stores along the way, and they are called Chicago screws. So once that's all done, bring it back the other way. And you can neaten your ribbon up as you go along, just to make sure that it's not creased and overlapping and stuff like that, so that it looks as pretty as possible. And then you want your last piece to come across here, so that you can then tie it at the front of the book. So once I have that, I'm going to tie it in a nice tight bow. You don't have to knot it first. The ribbon will stay in place once it's all bound. Make it into a bow, trim off your ends, and then you can finish decorating the book with different details. So on this one, I've just done an organza ribbon. It's a nice thick ribbon as well, so it works very well for binding. And then I've done the lace and just finished it with a flower. And on this one, I'm going to put the name of my bride and groom on the front. So thank you again for joining us at Oakville Paper Boutique and Rosie's Picks. You can find us at oakvillepaper.com. You can email us at info@oakvillepaper.com. And also you can find us on Instagram, Twitter, and Pinterest. Thank you, and please join us for our next segment.